I really like building things for other people, especially when they have a crazy idea. MrBeast needs a jet car to jump an entire football field worth of school buses. I say we're gonna overshoot it by about 50 feet if we actually hit 100.
Wow.
To make this work, we need a few things. We need a car, we need a ramp, we need some jet engines, and we need a driver. Now that I know what needs to be done, time to get to work.
He's the one that's going to be driving the RC system.
Here's our fuel cells right here. Fuel pumps, engine ECUs, data terminals with all the telemetry for the engines there. Last but not least, 7 jet engines. We're going to fill it up with fuel, get these things started.
Never seen anything like this in my life.
We got everything together, everything's on.
I think I'm ready, dude.
All right, Sophia, hit it. All our testing is done. Now it's time to get this car on the trailer and take it to MrBeast. We're gonna pull over soon. I'm gonna hook up to Donut Media's rig and steal some power. They're gonna tow charge me for about 30 or 40 miles. And then we're just gonna keep on going to our destination. And the Donut Media guys said that they burned a half a tank of fuel, and now it feels like they're not hauling anything with their truck since I'm not connected. I started up the generator in the back, and as you can hear, it's doing its hybrid thing. We got another 600 miles to go. This is now the next day, 11 a.m. in the morning. We left at 2 p.m. yesterday afternoon, and we've been driving direct. The only sleep we got was at a rest stop for about an hour and a half, and then we were right back on the road. But we're finally here. Getting here was a huge relief. Next thing, I gotta get together with the donut guys, test the RC system, test and run the jet engines, make sure everything's working good, and then hope that all my calculations for the ramp are correct. I went with a really aggressive ramp angle here and a ramp speed of 100 miles per hour. Any slower than that and we're gonna fall short. Any faster than that, we could possibly go into the trees. If they get the speed wrong and it's like 20 or 30 miles per hour over what we calculated, then yeah, it's going in the trees.
Oh God.
I don't think it's very probable. However, I soon realized that I drastically overestimated the amount of power that a 1997 Firebird has. I also thought the track was longer than it was. You'll see what I mean later, but for now, let me get to testing this RC system. I'm now in full control of the car using the RC remote, and Nolan looks sort of terrified.
I know it sounds crazy, but I actually just wanna just hit this and go and hit that ramp.
I don't wanna do that.
That's me. You good, Nolan?
Yeah.
I know it's a little unnerving being in the driver's seat while I'm driving.
That's not what bothers me.
Just remember, if you hit the brake with your foot and that comes off, you're not going to have control with that.
It's
just the way I made it in case of safety.
Yeah.
So just try to do it with that.
Yeah,
and then, okay.
All right.
Thanks, good luck, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, if you want to play with it. So here's the throttle. This is the brake. You don't even need to pit, and this is the steering.
Okay, so I turn this into hypothetical wheel turn.
There you go.
Look at your front wheel.
Wait.
Oh my God. Oh, that's so cool. Where is Chris when you need him? Chris would kill with this. It is very cool, but I'm worried. I don't know, I'm just used to things breaking.
Now that I run tested the RC system and I'm extremely confident that nothing's gonna go wrong.
I love it, I love the confidence. Let's do it.
If this works, I will be thoroughly shocked.
Next thing we need to do is fill up the tanks with jet fuel, test run all 7 jet engines.
We're gonna teach 3 of these the fuel mapping.
Next, we need to get the car at the end of the track, launch it, and hope that everything works the way that I designed it.
All right, here we go. Starting the jet engines. The ramp is over there. Ready to rock and roll.
All right.
Send the jet engine!
Go.
Full throttle. Hit it, hit it.
All right, here it
Let's look at that jump one more time on the in-car camera from start to finish. All my calculations were based on a minimum ramp speed of 100 miles per hour to clear the buses. The distance from the starting point to the ramp is 0.42 miles. I'm on the side of the track controlling the jet engines. Nolan is in complete control of the car with the RC remote. Let's go.
This was great. That was so epic. Thank you. Absolutely. I appreciate it.
Yeah, appreciate
thank you. Thank you for steering. Thank you, man.
Thank you.
This went amazing.
This was really nerve-wracking for everyone because any calculation or anything that wasn't planned out properly would have resulted in catastrophic failure. If you see two cars there, it's because this was part of a bigger experiment that's on MrBeast's channel. I'll put a link to that video in the description below. And I want to personally thank MrBeast and his crew for being awesome to work with, as well as everyone from Donut Media. Thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next video. Had some serious damage. Look at that wheel.
I think it'll still run.